Workshop maps have revolutionized the way we train in Rocket League. Unfortunately, though, if you're somebody who doesn't train workshop maps, you're gonna get passed up by the people who do. So today, I'm gonna be breaking down the best workshop maps to train at every rank to hopefully help take your car control from zero to hero. If you're new to the channel though, only a small percentage of people who watch the videos are subscribed. So if you do find this video helpful, consider subbing. We're on the road to 200K, subbing is completely free and you can always unsub whenever you want. Anyways, let's go over the best workshop maps in Rocket League. All right, starting from the bottom, guys, we're gonna hit bronze and silver together here because in all honesty, I think workshop maps are really not catered towards bronze and silver players. If you are watching this and you're bronze or silver, my recommendation is to start out just training in free play and with the starter packs. But if you really, really wanna get into workshop maps, I was able to do some digging and find one map for bronze and silver players that I liked called Noob Dribble. Now, the reason I like this map is because it's super basic, but it gives you enough space and enough direction to help get a new player comfortable with controlling the ball. Now, by no means is this map gonna turn you into a mechanical god, but for starters, it's a great thing to do to just get more comfortable with controlling your car and more consistent with hitting the ball, which is why I place Noob Dribble as the best workshop map for bronze or silver players. Moving on to gold though, we can now get into some more of the proper workshop maps and hit the first rings map on the list, Speed Jump Rings 2 by DMC. Now just like with gold and silver, there aren't that many maps that I can really confidently recommend to a gold player in the workshop. But if I had to pick one, Rings 2 is probably the best starter map to begin with if you're looking into getting started training your aerial car control with rings. The reason I think this is the best starter rings map is just because it's probably the most forgiving rings map. The rings are fairly easy to go through, there's not too many sharp turns, and overall, the map is pretty brief. So it's a great place to get started learning how to control your car in the air. That's why Speed Jump Rings 2 is best for the gold ranks, in my opinion. Moving up though, getting into plat, we start to get into a little bit more of the gray area. But regardless, I did my best to select two maps for the plat ranks. And my first one is one that many of you probably don't know about yet. It's Lethemir's new private Neon Rings map. This was supposed to be the successor to the giant of workshop maps, that is his Giant Rings map. And so when Leth dropped it a few days ago, I had to hop on the Patreon and get early access. But from the little bit of testing that I've been able to do, Neon Rings for me was actually a little easier than his other Giant Rings map. And to be clear, the maps are very different. What I noticed was that his old Rings map was easier at the start, but much, much harder at the end. But overall, when playing through Neon Rings, I felt much less challenged than I did on his previous Giant Rings map. And so that's why I'm gonna go ahead and put Neon Rings first in the plat ranks. The other map though that I wanted to mention for plat players is a little bit of a less popular one called Hornet's Nest. Now I was actually just turned on to this workshop map by a guy in my private coaching program that I'll talk more about later, but the best way I can explain it is it's basically a gauntlet of levels where objects are going to be sent at you and your goal as the player is to use this cage that you're in to maneuver around the obstacles and last as long as you can. The reason I like this map and the reason I'm putting it in the plat ranks is because I think it does a great job of forcing you into awkward situations and getting you comfortable with being on the walls and on the ceiling, which is something that, in my opinion, you should expose yourself to as early as you can. That's why Hornet's Nest and Neon Rings get my two spots in the plat ranks. Moving into the diamond ranks though, I know I've been talking about the less popular workshop maps. Here is where I'm gonna hit on what are, in my opinion, the big three workshop maps that everybody who plays Rocket League and has access to should have downloaded. The first is going to be the fan favorite, Lethemir's Giant Rings, or his Lava Rings reskinned version. Now, like I said, this is the king of workshop maps. There is so much to be practiced inside here. There's so much variance across this individual map. In my opinion, it's the most complete rings map. And so far, there's just no map that even comes close to beating it. So if you're in Diamond, Lethemir's Giant Rings. The two other packs, though, that I wanted to hit on here are Dribble Overhaul 2 and Aim Training by Coco. The premise of this map is super simple. It's basically just a shooting gallery that allows you to practice your shot consistency, but this map is so crucial in my opinion because consistency is one of those things that I think holds a lot of players back the most. So if you're in the Diamond Rakes especially, you're going to want to practice Aim Training by Coco for at least a little while. That last pack that I want to mention though for Diamond players is going to be Dribble Overhaul 2. Now you've probably seen this pack mentioned in other YouTube content before, but just as Lethemir's Rings is the king of rings maps, Dribble Overhaul 2 is the king of dribbling maps. There are some things trained in this map, like catching the ball and dribbling the ball around obstacles, that I think is really transferable over to games. But since these maps are all a little trickier, Dribble Overhaul, Lethemir's Rings, and Aim Training go to the Diamond ranks. Stepping it up to Champ, we have two maps, both by DMC, Speed Jump Rings 3 and Speed Jump Rings 1. Now, since we're at the Champ ranks, I'm raising the bar a little bit for aerial car control. And each of these maps are great rings maps, but they're noticeably trickier right off the bat than the other maps are. For me, Speed Jump Rings 3 is my go-to training map. If I only have a little bit of time to warm up before playing, this is the map I go to, and it's probably the map you see a lot of on YouTube because it's versatile, it's tough, but it's also pretty quick. Speed Jump Rings 1, on the other hand, is probably equally tough, a little less versatile, and noticeably longer, which is why I listed it here, but if I had to pick one, I'd definitely take Rings 3. But either way, you can't go wrong. Those are my picks for the Champ ranks. Moving on to Grand Champ though, I have two maps I want to share here, but I want to start with a little warning before I share them. And the only reason is because the maps up until this point have been a little less tricky. I know I've broken up a ton of these maps across the ranks in the order that I think you should train them, but the reality is, even if you're Diamond, you could probably get through some of those Champ maps, and even if you're Plat, you might be able to get through a good part of those Diamond Workshop maps. With these maps I'm about to list though in the Grand Champ and SSL brackets, if you are not Grand Champ or at least pretty close to it, you are going to struggle. It's not gonna be a good time training these maps. So just be warned before you try these ones. But without any further wait, my two Grand Champ training packs are going to be Lethemir's Dribble Challenge and Lucid Rings. I'll have footage of both of these maps on screen, but if you understand Rings and you understand Dribble Challenge 2, all you need to know is these are the more unforgiving versions of those packs. So if you ever get to the point where you're finding Lethemir's Rings too easy or Dribble Overhaul 2 too easy, if you are in that boat, you can give these maps a shot as sort of challenge packs. But just know that these are challenge maps and are not meant to be easy. Finally, moving on to my last two recommendations for workshop maps. They could honestly be clumped as one, but my picks for any of you Supersonic Legends watching right now are going to be Impossible Rings 1 and Impossible Rings 2. Now, I tried to run through these maps just for the sake of getting you guys some footage for this video, and let me tell you, no matter how good you are at the game, these maps will make you feel like you suck. I guess there's a reason they call them impossible, and if there are any maps in this list that you could live on equally happy never having tried, it'd be these two. That's why the two Impossible Rings get my pick for the SSL ranks. Quickly though, before I forget, I did want to hit on a few honorable mentions before I wrap this up. Firstly, one map that I've seen people train that I tried to train for the first time today is Air Dribble Gauntlet. Now, I've seen this recommended in other YouTube videos, and I thought it didn't look too bad at first, but this map is on the level of Impossible Rings. even as somebody who's very, very comfortable with air dribbles in-game, I've had so much trouble just understanding how to get the takeoff inside this map. But I do know some people like it, so I wanted to make sure I at least put it in as an honorable mention in this video. And then the other two maps I wanted to give honorable mentions to are Speed Jump Boost and Obstacle Course by DMC. Now, once again, the reason I'm giving these maps as honorable mentions is because I think the trickiest part about these maps is actually understanding how they work and not necessarily completing them. I don't know about you guys, but when I play through, honestly, all three of these honorable mentions, I feel like the reason they're challenging has less to do with my actual car control and more to do with just understanding the tricks inside the maps. And I don't know about you, but personally, that's not the type of training I want to do, because that training isn't really what transfers to your actual in-game play, right? Just knowing the shortcut inside a map really isn't going to do you any good when you actually get thrown into an in-game situation. But I know there are some diehard fans of these maps, so I wanted to make sure I at least threw them out there and gave you a chance to look at them regardless. But there you have it, guys. Those are my top picks for the best workshop maps in Rocket League. Understand that my rating had to be a little bit arbitrary, right? I needed to assign some workshop maps to every rank, and so this list might not be picture perfect, but generally speaking, I think this is one of the best training progressions you can follow to level up your car control in Rocket League. If you're new to the channel though, my new live coaching program is currently accepting applications for our summer launch. As of the time I'm uploading this, we're in week 3 of spring training, and applications for the spring roster were already super competitive. So if you're interested in getting coached by me, I highly, highly recommend you send in an application as soon as possible to maximize your chance to reaching the interview stage for the summer launch. Also, the best way to interact with me going forward is going to be to catch me when I'm live on Twitch. I'm streaming every Sunday and randomly throughout the week as well, so make sure you follow me on Twitch to be the first notified when I go live. Beyond that, I'm doing a massive push on all my socials right now, including my Discord, TikTok, and Insta. So if you want to get in on giveaways and other content, make sure you're following me over there. But to those of us who can use workshop maps to train smarter and not harder, to us I say, aerial car control is coming. Thanks, guys.